is going on, folks? Dara here from D&D's Cocktails, and in today's video we have a little bit of a different one for you today, and it's a shorter one as well. It's just a wee bit short. It shouldn't be that long, but we'll see the events that I'm going to start rambling on for. But yeah, this is actually a request from a good mate of mine called Aoife Bonner. So thanks for this, Aoife. We will make sure to do it for you now. The cocktail that she did request was a apple martini, so an apple tini. Basically, the apple tini that I'm going to make these today, instead of it being that they're mixed stuff that's usually used in bars and stuff like that there, I'm just going to show you a not so awkward way to make it. You're only going to need three ingredients, obviously a shaker, ice, etc. And yeah, this is basically a vodka martini. So if you know, as you know myself, I've done a martini video before on the channel. It was a James Bond style martini. It was a shaken on the third one. That one was made with gin and vodka. This one today is just going to be made with vodka straight up. And it is a shaken martini, not a stirred one. So yeah, let's get straight on this. Also, just before we continue, make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below if you want your cocktail featured in the next video. And make sure you tell me what cocktail it is, just so I can shout you out at the start of the video, just like Aoife. So let's get this started for yourselves now. What you're going to need is you're going to need some apple schnapps. So I'm using some Tichiné, if that's how you pronounce it. I don't even know where this is from. Where do I see? Tichiné is from Spain. So there you go. It's basically Tichiné, green apple cider. Cider, schnapps, and I'm just going to use some Manky vodka. This is just Irish vodka, plucked up in Bundoran. I won't be able to give you a link to where to get this specific vodka, but honestly, any vodka you have works grand. This is just what I have in the house. And I thought, well, I haven't used it in a video before, so I may as well give it a go here now. And this is just some fresh squeezed lemon juice. I know I usually cut my lemons on camera, but just for handiness, and I was taking up a load of room in the fridge, I've decided just to go ahead and juice it pre-video. So let's move this cocktail glass out of the way. Actually, what I'm just going to do, just for a little extra bit of a style there, I suppose, style probably isn't the right word, is I'm actually going to stick a couple of ice cubes on there, give it a nice stir, and we're going to set that over to the side to chill. So like I was saying there, this is a shaken vodka martini instead of a stirred one. So basically what you're going to need, first of all, is you're going to need 1.5 ounces or 45 ml of your vodka. Like I was saying, I'm using some Minky Irish vodka. So we're going to get 1 ounce. Like so. And then we'll stick another ounce or half ounce on there. 1.5 of vodka. Next, what you're going to need is, you can, depending on your taste, now I like apples, if you don't really want it to be too much of a apple taste, then obviously you can put less in, but I'm going to just put in 3/4 of an ounce or 25.5 ml of my apple vodka, or not apple vodka, my apple schnapps. You can use 1/2 ounce if you'd like, depending on how much you want. And I'm just going to use 1/4 ounce of our fresh lemon juice here, like so. Next of all, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get some ice and stick it on our cocktail shaker. So we'll get a little bit of ice here. Let's see. Now, we do want this to be a little bit diluted because it's vodka. There's not really much mixture in it. Usually I would stir it around like this, but just because there's lemon juice on it, I'm going to give it a nice wee shake here. So we'll put it on, we'll give this a shake for about 10 to 15 seconds. So, about 10, 15 seconds. Then I'm just going to pour it over here so you can see me pour it. Then we're going to get our ice, our cocktail glass, dump that out. And we're just going to double strain this into our martini glass or a cocktail glass, just whatever's handy. Like Now, if you'd like, you can garnish as a wreck everything in the house. If you'd like, you can garnish this with an apple slice, but I have no green apples in the house at the moment, so I'm just going to leave it ungarnished. But yeah, that is a apple martini, or an apple tini, depending on what way you look at it. Obviously, I'm going to give this a taste now, see what it's like. Ah, lovely. Very tart. Very sweet at the same time, weirdly enough. I will say the lemon's a little bit lost in this drink, but it's definitely there, it's just not as prevalent as a lot of the other cocktails it would make. But the apple is really strong, and obviously because vodka is a neutral spirit, you can't really taste it anyway, it just gives you a little burning sensation, but lovely stuff. I'll tell you what, I'm a big fan of martinis, normally, but I think this is probably one of the nicest ones I've made in a while. But yeah, that was the apple martini. Nice short video for yourselves. I'll leave a link in the description for this T&A apple schnapps. If I can find a link for the monkey vodka, I'll put that down. But yeah, other than that, I hope you liked the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, all that there. Comment down below if you want your cocktail showed on a show or on a video, I suppose. Thanks again to Aoife for the suggestion. Fantastic. Right, folks, I'll see you all later. Like, subscribe. Oh, also, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, whatever. Subscribe, sign the subscription down in the description. Also, everything you need, like the measurements, is down there too. So, always check the description. But anyway, folks, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you all later.